There you go.
I think we're being followed again.
And what do we have here?
Me. Don't you recognize me? Maybe you don't recognize me without my helmet. It's still me. She's a nippy one out here tonight. Just went walk around the block. Okay, let's see what it is here.
Feels awfully nippy.
What's the temperature in Dryden, Ontario?
In Dryden, Canada, it's minus 21 degrees.
Oh yeah, it's a little nippy. Nice night for a walk. So apparently CK made a little video for you guys, and I figured I better at least make an appearance.
Apparently this is what we've been up to for the last few months. We kind of bit off more than we could chew, but we kind of got it going, and it's pretty cool. You want us to give you a little tour behind the scenes like nerds?
See the brains of the outfit.
Okay, let's go take a look.
So yeah, we wanted to make a new light display this year. Not that we know what we're doing, but we should have started like months earlier than we did. I think we started when, September or something?
Yeah, probably.
And we still had our old lights like this, and then the snowman, and on the outline of the house that we wanted to incorporate into it. So we needed something that we could hook into the old ones too. So anyways, let's give you a little tour here. I think we need a light. I got a flashlight in here. Okay, so I don't usually walk around with a big trouble light in my pocket, but hey. Now, the wiring is kind of a mess, but it turned really cold the day we finished. And that's the way it stayed. Brass band hooked us up, and Northbound Moose too, eh?
Yeah.
Hooked us up with this frame. It's an old trampoline frame.
Yeah.
But it was too big, so we pulled it in and made this pipe to go across the back and welded it in and welded up at the front. And then we have a pole, I can't really see it, with a clampy thing in there for the pole, holding the strips up. It's got a bit of a wow to it, but so far so good.
And how tall is it? It's supposed to be 12 and a half feet.
No.
Plus the star.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's tall.
15 feet or something.
It's taller than the house, I think.
The main one here? Should have really did this in the daytime, but this is the main
guts.
Can't see the writing right now. When it starts up, there's little screen there, and Cat 5 cables run to this other box. This one's for the star, this one's for the tree, and then that other one runs away over that way to the
AC
controller. Oh, that one's got some nice lights in it. That's romantic. I don't care what you say, that's romantic. Huh?
Amazing it works in the cold.
Yeah, it's been good. It's been going since, when did we finish?
I think we December 2nd we fired it up.
And hasn't glitched out yet. There, one more box we'll check. How does this one open? Remember?
That one's...
The don't want to get that snow in there.
This in here is where our AC lights hook into. There's 16 different channels. I think we're just using 5. Room for expansion.
More props next year. So we have speakers playing out here. They're turned down right now.
Because of the copyright police.
For people walking by, but most people are driving by in their cars. So we had this sign made, and we have an FM transmitter. So if you turn your radio to 99.9 FM, you can hear the music that goes to the tree and the rest of the lights.
Yeah, the lights just aren't random. They go to the music. I should have said that. Might be able to put a little clip in there. Or not. See how it goes.
Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin laid an egg. The Batmobile lost the wheel and Joker got away. Hey! Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin laid an egg. The Batmobile lost the wheel and the Joker got away.
So if anybody else is into this kind of thing and uses X lights and wants to share their display, just post the link in the comments below and everyone can enjoy.
So yeah, like I said, I think CK's got a video here for you. I have no idea what she put in it, but I figured I better make an appearance and just like to thank you all for sticking around and Merry Christmas and all that good stuff. Happy New Year and Happy Holidays to all of you out there and everyone that is still hanging around.
Thanks for those on Instagram, Facebook, and all our Patreons.
Oh, Facebook. Yeah, don't mention
Cubby
that.
Cubby has a funny story about Facebook. Do you want to share that, Cubby?
Well, I don't really want to share it, but I guess I could. Apparently, I'm banned from Facebook forever. It'd be different if I had did something, but I didn't do anything. One day I was looking and I thought, these are all weird ads, so I wonder why I'm seeing these. So I click on it, why are you seeing these ads? And it says, these are based on your age. So I thought, huh, I wonder what I have set in there. So I go look. And yeah, okay, I had it set to 1905, but still. So I was on the phone, that was the first mistake. Should have did it on the computer, but. And it's got like a little wheelie thing there. And you spin it to change the date. So I'm on 1905, so I'm spinning it, and it's like Wheel of Fortune or something. And it's going, and it's going, and it's going, and it goes all the way to the end. And it said I was 1 year old, and then the app crashed. So I didn't think nothing of it. And then a few hours later, get this email from Facebook saying I'm too young to be on there.
He wanted you to send your picture, government ID, to prove you were old enough to be on Facebook.
Yeah, so we sent one thing. Oh, no, I think what might have... They wanted my picture first, so I thought, well, no. So I sent them a cartoon picture. I don't think they like that. It's probably improvement, though. But so then they wanted a government thing. So we sent a couple, and it wasn't good enough for them. So then, bye-bye. 30 days, but what I find it interesting is after the time period was up where I'm officially banished, all of a sudden the address that I use for Facebook just starts getting major junk mail. Might be just a coincidence, but just saying. So yeah, I guess I'm not on Facebook anymore.
So beware you put your age correctly, or if you're 1 year old, you're too young to be on Facebook.
Yeah. I broke Facebook. So thanks again, everybody, and Merry Christmas. Hope you're all staying safe, and sit back and put your feet up and watch the rest of the video.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Stay safe out there.
Thanks for watching.
Bye for now.
So yeah, that's about it. That's the tour. It didn't cost you a cent. Oh, no.
Yeah.
There, can you see us now? Just like Hollywood. Hey. What's going on? It's me. Me. You probably don't recognize me without my helmet on. I look pretty good. Is it recording?
Yeah.
Oh, you're covering the holes.
Okay, let's try that again. CK's phone had had a full charge before we started, and this cold just sucked it right out of it and died. And now for the news. See the microphone? No, okay. So that's about is, my lips are freezing up. That's gonna about do it. Does that sound good? No. Hello? She's not very good weather for this kind of thing, but anyways.
Everybody, I know you haven't heard from us in a pretty long time, so figured it was time we gave you guys a bit of an update. I'm out on the Kodiak grooming the trails here. Kodiak hasn't seen much action for quite a while. I just realized it has just under 6,000 kilometers on it, but it's still an awesome ATV, so good to give it a bit of a run once in a while. So yeah, you haven't missed a whole bunch. Do have some updates for you. Last time that we went riding was, oh my goodness, maybe back in the spring even? Can't even remember. We did some maintenance on the Grizzly and we did make a video. Cubby hadn't been able to edit it though, so you haven't seen that yet, but you're gonna see it in this video, so a bit of a flashback. You can see probably that we had this big snowstorm mid-November, and it was about a foot of wet, heavy snow, and so all these trees, this skinny, mainly the balsam and spruce, just snapped them. So we've been able to clear a little bit of the trails, but not a whole bunch. So probably the biggest update, and kind of a sad one, is that we lost our poor Oliver last May. So the house has sure been quiet without him, and we miss him terribly, but lots of great memories. Jethro just turned 14, end of November, so we're feeling fortunate to have him with us, and every day is a bonus for sure. And what else has been happening? Cubby was on new medication for most of the summer, trying to treat his Lyme. And then he went off it, and about a month ago he got retested. We sent the blood away to a lab in Germany again, and some positive news. So although he's really not feeling much better, the test showed that, like, originally there'd been, I think, 5 positive tests for the Lyme bacteria. Now it's down to 1. So that's really good news to know that stuff has been working and that all of this has not been in vain. But there's still some viral infection going on, and here I'm out on the lake. Not a lot of snow because we had some really mild weather. Hey. Anyways, so still a viral infection, still something going on, so, and still a trace of the Lyme bacteria. So hoping that this coming year will be the year where he starts feeling a lot better and we can get back to doing all the stuff we've got planned. And what else is happening? So we did a Christmas light display this year. Kind of had it been thinking about it for a while, and we started using these RGB pixel lights, and more computer programming with them, and we got this mega tree. And anyways, we didn't even know there was going to be a city contest for the Christmas lights this year, but we got it up and we entered and we won the city display, so that was kind of cool. Nice to see lots of people stopping by the house and checking out the show. I think if we'd known how much work it was actually going to be, we might not have tackled it. I spent days and days pushing these little pixel lights, 800 of them, plus more actually, into these strips of plastic for this tree. But it was well worth it in the end. Still see cruising along here. There's one of the trails and all covered in trees. Cubby's just not healthy enough to be able to clear them all. This one too, we used to walk that way. It's crazy how much damage it did. See them just bent over. Haven't ridden the Grizzly or the Beast all summer. I've just been moved around the yard. And so hopefully, like I said, this spring and summer we'll get Cubby feeling better. He's gonna be on a new bunch of meds to see if he can get his immune system back where it needs to be and feeling better. Of course, darn COVID is causing all kinds of problems for everybody, and with his immune system being pretty well non-existent, we have to be so careful. Finish off my grooming here up what we've nicknamed Black Diamond. It's a bit of a kind of side hill, tricky. Get up off the seat and get ready to bail if it goes the wrong way kind of trail. Oh, there's another dead squatch along the trail. I just realized I think I just saw a dead squatch. I better go back just in case he was sleeping. Huh. Oh, I think he's dreaming. Yeah, he's not dead. That's good. Cubby, what are you doing there? Oops.
I think I'm being followed. Oh boy. Hope they're friendly.
Well, on that note, I just wanted to wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a happy and healthy 2022. Thanks for all your support this past year, and hopefully we'll see you guys more a lot next year. Thanks, everybody. So I think it's time to get some new wheel bearings for the Grizzly. Ever since we changed them last time, they seem kind of loose, but I think this is a little too loose. So that's why you don't use a regular socket when you're using an impact gun. Cubby's new 3/4 inch impact gun broke the socket. So we didn't have any metric impact sockets, so we're gonna have to give this standard one a try. Well, that made short work of that. Okay, so we got it off. Just gotta clean this up a bit, get that snap ring out of there, and then press that bearing out. So we're using Cubby's new press. It's been sitting in the garage for a couple years and finally got a chance to use it, and sure is coming in handy. I think that's gonna do it. So that went together good. Now it's time to put it back on the Grizz. So you want to make sure you use your proper torque specs when you put this back on. So you got to make sure that nut's tight. I think it's like 190 foot-pounds. Look at the difference now. No slack like before. So we got the other side off, and look at this. Definitely lots of slack in there. When you go like that, can you hear all that grindy noise? Ugh. Definitely was time to change them. So the front went really well, and now we're gonna tackle the back. Hopefully they'll go as good. It's kind of cold and raining today, so we're inside in our little shed, out of the weather. So the backs are similar to the front. You got the big nut here, of course, and we got a couple bolts for the caliper, and there's a bolt here and one down there that we got to take off. These two bolts here are where the tracks go on, so hopefully should go good. So the last bearings we used were Pivot Works. They lasted okay, but they always seem kind of slack right from the beginning. So this time we're going to try all balls and see how that works out. So it took us a while, but finally got those wheel bearings all changed. The back went really good, actually, so happy about that. We tried the all balls bearings this time, so they're available from Kimpex. They have a bunch of other brands as well, so we'll put a link in the description below, and we're gonna take it for a little test ride. Grizzly, go. So we're just picking up this wood that we cut from this tree that we'd fallen down and cut up a while ago, and cut some more up. But we just noticed we have a flat tire on the trailer, so I gotta boogie home and hopefully make it across the ditch. So away I go. No time to spare. Taylor definitely has a lean on it now. We haven't used the trailer for years and years. Cubby built it, and we just kind of parked it and stored old junky metal in it, and realized that it probably would be handy to use for wood and maybe out at Area 52. So we also got some little chunks here from a tree that had fallen across the trail, so I'm gonna stop and pick those up. All right, so I picked up that little load of little baby wood there, and I'm gonna go tackle heading home. Cubby's behind me, but I'm gonna make the corner here. Wouldn't normally be too bad, except I have that super flat tire on the trailer. So the grizzly's grunting. But we're trucking her. Alright, so the last stretch. Nice and slow. Brakes, grizzly brakes. Now I've switched to diff lock. Good. I think. Made it. Well, there's your problem. Made it though, but pretty well sure the tire's shot now. Oh well. Good test for the grizzly. That tire had all cracks in it anyways. You could actually hear it leaking, so I'm not really surprised, but wheel bearings work good. And we got a good load of wood.
That's a wrap.